So the Cork House was really an attempt to completely rethink construction compared to most modern buildings, where the external wall has separate layers for waterproofing, insulation, airtightness. This was this idea from the architects Matt and Dido, which could the entire wall be made out of one material? Could that material be cork? So cork is actually the natural bark of the cork oak tree. And I think what's rather nice is that you can sort of shear off the bark almost in the way that you shear a sheep, and that bark will then regrow over the next 9 or 10 years. So it sort of naturally replenishes. And as you pull off this layer, it's perhaps 30, 40 millimeters thick, these great slabs of the cork. But if you go to Portugal, where most of the cork forests are, you can see the huge volumes of this raw material sort of stacked up. And now to make a wine cork, you literally press the cylindrical corks out of these slabs. And what you can imagine that leaves is the sort of blank with all the holes in it. That gets crumbled, put into a sort of a giant cake tin and heated. And when it's heated, the natural resins, the suberin, comes out of the cork and then sort of glues it all together. And that's these sort of dark, baked, dark cork blocks that we end up with, an absolutely natural product. So this was a real experiment. It was taking in some ways, a natural and quite an old material, but combining it with new technology, in this sense of computer machining, to accurately machine these large blocks. And so it's not necessarily saying that we should be building the future out of cork. What it's saying is, let's rethink how we build. Let's see if we can make a future which is better, which is more sustainable. So you approach the cork house and it sits in this wonderful garden. There is actually a cork tree in the garden. This building has been created out of nature. It's taking this natural product and turning it into this structure. And it's incredible because it's the first time I've been in a building where you can not only see the material, but you can also smell it and you can hear it. You can smell it because the cork has been corked. So there's almost this sort of wonderful burnt charcoal, burnt toffee sort of smell. And you can hear it because the cork obviously absorbs sound. It's used even when you want to make anechoic chambers. And so there's this wonderful sort of peace inside the house. So actually having the opportunity to spend a night there, and you wake up inside, there's everything you can see around you. You look up, you're looking up into this sort of pyramid of cork walls. And although it's a new building material, it's built in a really traditional way, much like we build bricks. And so the idea that you can see how the building is made, I don't think you need to be an engineer to appreciate that and the sort of the tactile nature of it.